prickly golden Goldenseal, also known as orange root, and Hydrastis canadensis. One of the best-selling botanicals, requiring at least 3 to 5 years to grow from the various initial propagation methods, this plant is as valuable as the time domain it takes, making it a golden plant. It does well in artificial shade if no woodland canopy is available, but generally grows under deeply rooted oak, poplar, walnut, and basswood trees, specifically where other woodland plants, such as bloodroot, grow well from moderately filtered sunlight, pre-draining sandy soil with continuous moisture, and in a moderate pH of rich organic matter. Use of this plant has been strictly medicinal except for commercial hygiene products. It should be considered for conservative use only, since heavy metals, safe, but possibly close, still below the recommended mass proportion limits, can exist in each dose, an amount of several metals that's even safer if reduced through cultivation in strict controlled conditions based on research. While some wild animals are known to enjoy eating the berries, helping distribute the seeds, the berries are not edible for humans. The usable roots and leaves make it most famous as a common antiseptic, which means it has antimicrobial, antifungal, and antiviral power. Goldenseal products offer specific topical, oral, immunity, respiratory, lymphatic organ, and digestive benefits, with eye and ear infection uses. For example, it can improve the lymphatic system by increasing blood flow to the spleen. The antiseptic properties of the medicinal acted against some notoriously disgusting bacteria, including Giardia lamblia, Candida albicans, Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, Chlamydia, Coronibacterium diphtheriae, Escherichia coli, E. coli, Salmonella typhi, Shigella dysenteriae, Trichomonas vaginalis, Neisseria gonorrhea, Neisseria meningitidis, and many others. With early contamination mitigation needs of early Martian colonists and constant antiseptic needs on Earth, what else can we learn about this amazing organism, and how can it help on the journey to and on Mars? Be sure to like and subscribe to the Martian Ark for more content, and leave your thoughts in the comments below.